Center here in New York City. Now, I know you're all wondering about, tonight's big report on James Woods Pro, but first, a word from our sponsors, Sudsy Suds. Sudsy Suds, Sudsy Suds, much more suds with Sudsy Suds. Knows more about Flaming Youth, Jazz Babies, High Society, and Low, James Woodsworth!
Thank you, Justin, so much!
My pleasure, James.
Love that Ted Loveland. He's wonderful. I'm here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, to put an end to that persistent rumor that motion pictures will talk. Isn't that a ridiculous idea? I've spoken to several film executives here in New York, and they all assure me the idea of talking pictures is a load of rubbish. Now here's something that's definitely the Cat's Whiskers. That madcap flapper, Pretty Polly Pepper, is about to inherit the diamond necklace known as the Ice Garden. It's worth a fortune and hasn't been seen in decades. It's not easy keeping up with Pretty Polly Pepper. I can see her now at the estate of her socialite aunt, Miss Augusta Granville, up to who knows what?
Maybe that's Miss Polly now.
Hi-ho, Andrew.
Good morning, Miss Winnie.
Hello, Andrew.
Hello, Miss Tweedles.
Lovely morning, isn't it, Andrew?
Yes, it is, Miss Bunny.
Is Polly here yet?
Not yet, Miss Daisy. But she's expected any moment.
Is she coming on the train?
Has someone gone to meet her?
No need.
You don't mean she's flying here to Southampton, Long Island, New York, from who knows where in an aeroplane?
Only a madcap flapper like Pretty Polly Pepper would do such a thing.
I'll travel on ground, thank you.
Miss Polly isn't coming on the train, and she isn't flying in. She's driving in her new Studebaker.
New Studebaker?
We didn't know she had a new Studebaker.
We didn't know she had an old Studebaker.
The Studebaker people gave her a new car for Posney size one. Seems they're gonna use the Pies on Publicity campaign. The car every young flapper should drive.
How do you like that? Pretty Polly Pepper in the publicity campaign.
Her picture is everywhere you look. Billboards, magazines, cigarette packs.
Some girls have all the luck.
I wish I could be in a publicity campaign. It would be the cat's pajamas.
Meow.
Good morning, young ladies.
Good morning, Mrs. Granville.
You're all coming to the party, aren't you? My niece would be so disappointed if you didn't attend.
We wouldn't miss it for the world.
Splendid.
Mommy and Daddy say the Ice Garden is well worth seeing.
I wish I had a fabulously valuable piece of jewelry like that.
We've only seen pictures of it.
You know what they say? A diamond always looks new. Hi, boys.
Hi, girls. Is Polly here?
Expect it any moment.
New Studebaker.
New Studebaker? That's something.
Sure is.
Mrs. Granville?
Yes, dear.
Why does Polly get the necklace on her 18th birthday?
That was her father's wish. He thought she would be mature enough at 18 to accept the responsibility of ownership. Mustn't forget, the Ice Garden is no ordinary necklace. It contains one large, perfect diamond set in the design.
I wouldn't want to do the shimmy wearing something like that.
Displaying the Ice Garden would not only celebrate Polly's birthday, it'd be the social event of the season. After all, the Ice Garden hasn't been seen for 40 years. Out here. I want to introduce them to Miss Polly.
Yes, ma'am. Duck and Duchess.
Hello, everyone! It's good to be back in Southampton, Long Island, New York.
It's good to have you back, Polly.
Thank you, Tommy.
Thanks to the dope.
It's going to be a wonderful party, Polly. Anyone who's worth knowing will be here.
Hello, it's Augusta Cat.
We haven't seen you in over a week.
What have you been up to, Polly?
Now, let me think. Not much. I entered a dance marathon and won.
Wow!
I had tea at the Astor Hotel with the mayor of New York,
Gentleman Jimmy Walker.
I helped a few girls bob their hair and kick and bow their lips. I've been to so many parties, I can remember them all. Oh, yes, I forgot. Mr. Florence Ziegfeld of the Ziegfeld Follies is going to let me audition. It's only for a bit in the course, but I think it will be scrumptious, at least for a week or two.
No, I'm like Polly.
You're the bee's knees.
Anything else?
I learned how to play the ukulele.
The ukulele?
Oh dear, I don't think the ukulele's ladylike.
It is if you're a flapper.
More.
I met this perfectly scrumptious cowboy, Buck Wayne. He's from Texas.
You've had a lot of living in 1 week.
I'll say.
You're a little mad, Polly Pepper.
I like spirited hijinks. Don't you? After all, we are flappers.
A girl of modern fashion, I'm a girl that's born in fashion, I'm a girl who's on the go, I'm a flapper. A girl who's unconventional, you bet that it's intentional. A one girl dying low, I'm a flapper. With my diamond bracelets, cupid lips, a beaded skirt that hugs my hips, short blonde hair, a fine close hat, pulled down hose, now how about that?
A girl sophisticated, I'm a girl emancipated, I'm a girl with savoir faire, I'm a flapper. A girl of independence, I'm a girl of social status, I'm a girl extraordinaire.
What's up and what's down?
Leave everything to me, Mrs. Grenville. I'll lighten your burden. The Duke is a financial wizard.
I've met a king before, Paul Whitman. The king is swing, but never a duke or duchess.
You have now, my dear. There's no need to feel impressed.
I'm not impressed. I get around.
This modern age, I would never completely understand it.
I'm for that warm bath, Aunt Augusta. And that sparkling polar fringe, fair ginger ale. See you around, Duke, Duchess.
Isn't my niece something special?
Charming, delightful, so perfect. Such confidence.
She gets that from my side of the family. I'm sure she has everything she needs.
I do want to explain about those Manchurian stocks. They're paying at 48%.
Sounds delightful. It won't be a moment. Maybe we can play a game of Mahjong later.
As soon as he hands over the check, let's head north for the border.
The border can wait.
What?
We're in high society territory. We can't rush these things. You don't have the patience.
This is too good a deal to mess up.
We're not going to mess it up.
How much do you figure she's good for?
Plenty.
Manchurian stocks and bonds at 48%.
48% of nothing. I want you to be something else. Who would think life could be such an easy one?
They have to carry on.
One of none, then the stake could change. Stocks and bonds, irresistible.
Stocks and bonds, indescribable.
Stocks and bonds, how remarkable.
48% going up by the minute. Stocks and bonds, how incredible.
Stocks and bonds, how delectable.
Stocks and bonds, get them all the trading tops.
Who would think life could be such an easy haul?
Cash and carry on,
wine and dine on, then the stink.
Ka-ching!
See ya, honey, we're in the money. Stocks and bonds, always in demand.
Stocks and bonds, we'll gladly lend a hand.
Stocks and bonds, the ticket to the promised land. Who would think that could be such a piece of cake?
Give and then we take.
Rock on, stack on, then the stink.
Ka-ching!
See ya, honey, we're in the money.
Stocks and bonds, irresistible.
And
stocks and bonds, indescribable.
And
stocks and bonds, how remarkable. 48%
going up by the
stocks and bonds.
Stocks and bonds, how mysterious.
Stocks and
bonds, I'm delirious. Stocks and bonds, get them on the trading tops. Look out!
make little cops around makes them nervous.
What are you gonna do about it?
I thought that Emily's sister's gonna help Biz. I'll think of something else.
I hope so. I need a steady paycheck. I get cranky when I don't eat.
Hello, losers! Ha 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 ha! Is everyone having a good time? Ha 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 ha! That's what I like to hear. Stay as long as you like. There's no school tomorrow.
Get caught.
You won't get caught because no one will know the necklace is missing.
I've had a perfect copy made of an old magazine.
I get ya. You swipe the genuine and replace it with the fake.
That's the general idea.
How will we get in the house?
You'll walk in.
Huh?
You'll be there long before the party gets. You'll have plenty of time to case the house. When it comes to heisting, Cheetah Hayes and Lugs O'Toole used to be the best.
We're still the best.
I hope I'm not interrupting anything.
Fluke. Lieutenant Fluke. How you doing, Coppa? What do you know? What do you guess?
You boys learned an orchestra?
I thought I might be able to use a couple of violins. You know, novelty act.
Who are you trying to catch, Frog Garden? These two clubs are bad news.
Leftovers from the Brewery Street gang. Should have left them in here. Might give the dump a bad name.
Why don't you give me a break, Flick? I'm only trying to make a couple of dollars.
I've told you before, the crazy cat is going out of business. Like it or not.
I don't like it.
Take it up with the commissioner. I intend to close every speakeasy in town.
Starting with this place, Frog Garden.
Lieutenant Fluke! How nice to see you again!
How nice to see you, Mr. Witch Girl.
Gathering material for your radio show?
Everywhere I look, there's material. Flappers, follies, nightclubs, police. I don't like crime, however. It's not nice.
You've got to take the bad and the good. That will make the 1924.
The Roaring Twenties. I like that phrase. I'll use it on my radio show.
Glory, 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 glory
My dear Duke, I'm trying very hard. I'm afraid I have no head figures. Maybe I should speak to my bakers.
No, no, no.
You mustn't do that.
Why not?
These Manchurian stocks and bonds are virtually a secret. If he told the bankers about them, word would spread.
It would?
The value of stocks and bonds might lessen.
I wouldn't want that.
Of course you wouldn't. It wouldn't be sensible.
It is every day I have royalty to advise me. It's quite an experience.
It's the sort of thing we do for all our friends. Think nothing of it.
How generous.
Today, the stocks and bonds are paying 48%. Tomorrow, they may only pay 47%. You mustn't delay.
Time is money.
That's what my husband used to say. How much money do you think I should invest?
It's entirely up to you, but the more you invest, the more you get back.
That makes sense. That makes sense. May I should invest 50, 60, 70, 80? Well, this is a nice round number.
Bingo!
Who should I make the check out to? Some man for a corporation, or to Duke and Duchess of Milford?
Make it out of cash.
Paul, and is he standing there? At Polly's birthday.
Don't wait too long, Mrs. Granville. We're leaving soon for Europe. 48% isn't offered every day.
I'm sure it isn't.
Remember, Mrs. Granville, not a word to the bankers.
I won't forget. See you on my job.
Aunt Augusta.
Yes, dear.
Where did you meet the Duke and Duchess?
Sailing back from Europe. They're marvelous, marvelous young players. That's why I invited them for a visit. Good mahjong players are hard to find. Old Polly is some young friends.
Edna, Amy, Georgia, and Theodore?
No, we need Tweedles, Buddy, and Daisy.
Hello, Mrs. Granville.
Girls, what have young things been up to?
Practicing our charts.
Hey, kids, they're playing this
land
on the polo ground.
Did you ever see this place?
This is what I call living.
Polo ground, swimming pool, fancy gardens?
An airplane parked on the grass like it was a taxi cab.
What is the real way to show up?
Mona took care of that. She gave Meech $20 and told him to get lost.
What do you know?
What do you guess?
Careful. Company.
About time we got here. I called the agency twice. There's a lot of work to be done.
Where do we start?
My name is Andrew. If you have any questions, I'm the one to ask. You have names, I suppose.
My name's Google.
My name is Sylvester.
My name is Rose Marie.
Don't bother, Miss Granville. This birthday party has got her in pins and needles.
Ouch!
Was that meant to be funny?
Sometimes the boys say things they shouldn't. They've got a warped sense of humor.
Easy, easy. I don't want to get the jacket wrinkles.
What have you got in those violin cases?
Change of shirt.
In case someone spills something on what we're wearing.
You know, like gravy or tomato sauce.
Oh, well, I see. They can't stand to wasting time. Come, follow me. I'll show you to the kitchen.
I better start getting ready for the party. After all, a girl doesn't turn 18 every day.
Only once in a lifetime.
Darn.
Save a Charleston for me, Polly.
Me too.
I can't wait to see the ice garden.
Is that the rock I keep hearing about?
I wouldn't call it a rock buck.
It's a diamond. A great big diamond.
It shines.
What's this case, Miss Polly?
What is it?
A telegram.
I love getting telegrams. I certainly didn't expect this.
What?
It's from Mr. Flo Zigfield of the Zigfield Follies. He says I'll have to audition within the hour. It's the only time he has free.
But it's your birthday, Polly.
Maybe you could take a fast train.
Or you could drive to New York in your fast new Studebaker.
There wouldn't be enough time. I did want to be in the chorus.
It's every flapper's dream.
No problem. We can fly to Manhattan in my plane. I'll get you there in no time.
What a wonderful idea.
Oh, Buck, I can hug you.
Be my guest.
Today is my birthday, and I'm going to give a beautiful diamond necklace and audition for the Zigfield Follies. I'm so happy I could.
What, Polly?
Charleston!
says the number is flat.
Flat!
He gave everything he had.
And then some.
He says the routine lacks something.
Like what?
He didn't say.
This is a scrumptious book. Being on the stage at the Ziegfeld Theater auditioning for great American showman, Flo Ziegfeld.
It's scrumptious if you say it's scrumptious.
Aren't you sweet?
Is there anything I can do for you?
I hope I'm not too late.
Too late for what?
Ziggy didn't give much notice.
I flew Miss Pepper in my plane.
Your own plane?
That's what I call easy travel. Where are you from?
Mr. Wing comes from, Arizona, New Mexico, Texas. I never can remember.
I know who you are. You're Polly Pepper.
You're in all the papers.
Yes, I flew. I entered these telegram.
May I see it?
Certainly.
I see.
Mr. Ziegfeld, there's a Polly Pepper here to see you. You sent her a telegram about an audition? Yes, Mr. Ziegfeld. Mr. Ziegfeld says to watch the routine and see if you can pick it up. Do you think you can do that?
I'll try.
Mr. Ziegfeld is always at the Society Flappers.
He says it's good for business.
Sometimes business is a personal favorite.
Not many Society Flappers make the grade.
You girls don't know Polly.
Can you sing? A little.
Can you dance?
A little. Where is Ziggy?
He's up there.
Where?
There. Don't worry about it. You can't see him, but he can see you. Yes, Mr. Ziegfeld? Right away. You'll have to leave the theater.
Do I have to?
Mr. Ziegfeld insists.
I won't be long, Buck.
Fine. I'll be waiting outside the stage door.
Are we ready?
We're ready. Hit it.
Sudsy Suds, bunch more suds with Sudsy Suds. Which are along the last two. Yeah, the suds super duper. There are the suds with super This episode of the Jam Postco Show will be pre-recorded in case anything happens during our transmission this afternoon on the grounds of the Grand Hill State here in Long Island, New York. And here he is, James Woodsboro!
Wonderful the way the New York City Police Department are dealing with gangsters and mobsters? Locking them up, I mean. I think it's swell. I've spoken to several film executives here in Manhattan, and they all assure that very shortly, motion pictures will talk. Isn't that what I've always said? Now here's a delicious tidbit. I have the best authority on it that Polly Pepper has auditioned for a chorus job in the next Ziegfeld Follies. Not that Polly has to worry about work, though. She has $1 million safely invested in stocks, thanks to a trust fund. If all goes well with our radio transmission, you'll see me broadcasting live from Polly's birthday party.
Fly me away, home. Holding you close by.
Zigzag's mom said.
We can't switch to necklaces until we find out where they hide in the ice garden.
I'm strictly a grab and run man. I don't like all this fancy pants society jazz.
For the price the ice garden will bring, I can like anything.
This house has more rooms than a hotel.
Did you find out anything?
Only that Mrs. Granville turned over the necklace at the party.
That's no good. We've got to make this move before that.
I bet I can blow out a call on the telephone. She's going to be very angry.
Tell her we'll think of something. We've got our reputations to think of.
You people have to work, not standing around making chit-chat. You, help me to the kitchen, help me with the pimento and cucumber sandwiches.
Yes, sir.
You two, help me set up tables around the tennis court.
Yes, sir. A self-respecting gangster shouldn't have to take orders from a butler.
We haven't got much time to pull off this caper.
What do you know? What do you guess?
I'm nervous about tonight.
If you don't stop telling me you're nervous, you're gonna make me nervous.
Hello, Mrs. Granville.
Care to join us? We're going to see the play.
No time. So much to do.
By the by, Mrs. Granville, that Manchurian stock is paying at 50%.
50%? That makes a pot. The book is down by the court, candles on every table, and the rain's beautiful rooms.
I don't think anyone is
humiliating.
The army
stuff
is all
about
here and there.
Yes, Granville. Cook says the birthday cake's ready for approval.
Yes, yes.
She doesn't know how you want the candles arranged.
Are you coming, Mrs. Granville?
Yes, coming soon.
The society editor from the New York Times is on the telephone.
Tell her I'll be right there.
Yes, Miss Granville.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking? It can't be, can it? The ice garden. Quick, make the switch before she comes back.
What?
Yeah, thank you, dolls everywhere.
What a party. What a fine joint.
Lovely party. Marvelous time. Can't recall when I've had such a good time.
Happy birthday, Polly.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday, Polly.
If I have to drink one more glass of that nauseating ginger ale, I'll turn into a polar bear.
It's about time we got that check.
We've earned it. Lejeune, ginger ale.
Let's get inside and put on the pressure.
How?
I'll tell her that insurance stock is paying at 103%.
That ought to do it.
This is just great. First they shut down my club, and now you call me all the way out here on a false alarm? I should have stayed in Manhattan.
But, Mona, we didn't have the medicine we called you.
I still think we should get out while the getting's good.
Mugs?
Yeah, Mona?
Don't think. We play it cool. I'm a guest here. No one knows me. You three are temporarily held. After the party, we'll slip away and no one will be the wiser. Understand?
Sure. We understand.
Keep that ice warm.
You can count on me.
I'm gonna take a walk around the place. You know, get a little fresh air. You three, stay in mission. Especially you, Trixie.
Me?
Don't pick up anything that doesn't belong to you.
Ouch, Mona. You think it's time for a shoplifter or something?
You said it. I didn't get lost.
I can't think of anything.
Think nothing of it, Mrs. Granville. Your husband did me a few favors when I was a rookie cop.
I must pay something. I said.
I won't take a penny.
Dad, make a donation to the policeman's party.
Fine by me.
Oh dear, it's almost time for the presentation.
I'll make myself scarce. You might not see me, but I'll be here. Some of my men too.
You may feel so secure.
That's what cops supposed to do.
Oh, just that justice. It's been far too long. Can
I see you today?
When do we get to see the ice?
Now's the time.
Wonderful! Isn't that wonderful, Dad?
Wonderful, girls.
Wonderful! Isn't that wonderful, girls?
If you say so, Mr. Woodsboro.
James Woodsboro here, ladies and gentlemen. Radio station WWW, atop the fabulous Long Island estate of Miss Augusta Granville. The birthday guests have assembled, and at any moment now, the wonderful Ice Garden Diamond Necklace will be revealed. The tension is melting!
Oh my goodness, where's Polly?
Polly! Polly! Polly!
Polly!
Excuse everyone, the birthday girl is up. Happy birthday, Polly! Doesn't matter to me.
You're a clever young woman, Polly.
What? Aunt Augusta, did you give the Duke and Duchess any money?
This is all a misunderstanding.
We'll pack and leave immediately.
No, you won't.
I have a good idea. Why don't we all go down to the polo grounds and have some cake and sparkling polymer ginger ale, and I'll open my other birthday presents.
Polly, your sweet is sagebrush at sunrise.
This has to be the happiest day of my life!
You saved the ice garden. You exposed those fresh and positive people.
I can't imagine what else can happen.
A telegram, Miss Polly.
It's probably someone wishing me another happy birthday.